A really handy feature inside IntegroMAT are text and binary functions. So those are these things, and by the end of this tutorial, you will know exactly how you can use them and what you can use them for. So let's just dive right in. So over here, we have a new blank scenario, right? So what we first need to do is we need to get some sample data so that I can show you some actual examples. So how I did that, I created a webhook over here and I put it in a tool called Postman. You don't have to use this, just what I think is handy to show you how this actually works. And this is what I'm going to send over. So I'm going to send over the full name. So here, Emma Doe, completely in capitals. Then the first name. And then here, what we could maybe do is we could do it lowercase. And then here we have the last name. We say Doe, and then the email address, emmadoe@gmail.com. So here I click OK. I click here, save, run once. And then here I send the data over. And then you see that we got some data over here. So, and what I'm about to show you works with any tool, right? It's just like a function inside IntegroMAT, works with any tool, but I just thought this is like a handy way to show you how this works. And then I can also show you some actual examples. So what we then do is here we click add another module. And then what we can do is we can say here, okay, set variable. So here tools, set variable. So this is just a native module inside IntegroMAT to set a variable that you can then use in some other modules. I can also show you that in a bit. So I want to show this first, explain how the variables work, and then I'm going to show you an actual example that might be handy to use. So here, variable name, I'm just going to call this example. This is how the variable will be called in the next modules. So a little bit like these, right? These are also variables. And then here, a variable value. And then what we can do is we're going to play around with these things and we're going to use the text and binary functions. So you can find those when you click in a field and then go to this A over here. And then here you see functions. And then you see that you have lots of different functions. So I'm going to explain most of these, not all of them, because some of them I've never used and I think you will probably also not need them if you are not a programmer. So here, for example, we have a length. So what you can do here, you can say, okay, length, and then you can put a word in it, and then you get the length of that thing. So I have to say myself, I've never used that, but it could be handy. For example, maybe you're posting tweets automatically on Twitter and you want to check how long that tweet is, something like that. So then you can use that. But so how all these things work, and you can also see that in these little examples that they show over here, is that you have these functions, you put these functions in. So for example, here, this one, lower, and then you get here, lower, and then you get these, I'm not sure you call these like not brackets, but these curved thingies, right? You know what I mean? And then you put something in between that, and that thing what's in between that will be affected by that function. So in this case, we have lower, and then here it also says converts all the alphabetical characters in a text string to lowercase. So if I would put here, hello, then if I click here, okay, and then I click here, run this module only, then you see that we get here, hello in completely lowercase. So that's how all of these work in general. So if we go over here, so we have lower, which makes everything lowercase, like I just showed. Then we have capitalize, which converts the first character in the text string to uppercase, which I think is, for example, handy for names. But you have to keep in mind that it's only converting the first character, so in this case, IntegroMAT, to uppercase, but it's not doing anything with all the other ones. So what I then would recommend to use, if you want to do something with names, is to use start case, because it capitalizes the first letter of every word and makes everything else lowercase. So if I have here start case, and if I would, for example, have here Emma completely in capitals, if I then click here, okay, and then here, run this module once, then you see now here that it capitalized the first letter and everything else is a lowercase. And obviously you do not have to type here. You can also just use the variables from your previous modules. So here, I, for example, have here first name, right? And you see here that it's written completely lowercase. And then here I click okay, save. And then for example, I click run once to test it. I will send some data again from Postman. I go over here and you see in a second, boom, we got the data. And then this happened with it. So here you see that we used the variable for first name and the output here is Emma and it capitalized the first letter and everything else is lowercase. So I think especially for that, these text and binary functions are super handy to do things with names, things that people actually see. Or for example, when I add someone to my email service provider, if they fill out a form somewhere, what I like to do is I like to lower the complete email address. Doesn't really matter, but just so that it looks a bit more neat inside my email service provider. So that's something what I sometimes do. So then you have that one. And then you have this. I have no clue how you pronounce it. AC or something. And this changes some characters. Like here, I guess this is the case in certain languages. So I think in English, this is not the case, right? Also not in Dutch. So if your language maybe has it, then you can convert this. Could be handy. Then you have replace. And replace is slightly different from these ones. So here you see that we always have a function and then we have this open thing and we have this close thing. And with replace, you see that we have the open thing, the close thing, and then we have also these things here. So the colons with like this comma. I'm also not sure how you call those. If you know, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to know. But here we replace. So if we would have here hello world, then what do you want to replace? Now, for example, hello, and I want to replace it by hi. So then this would happen. Run this module only, and then it says hi world. So this is really handy if you want to replace something in a sentence, something in a word by something, then you can do this. And what is also handy is you can also nest all these things in other functions. So you see here that we have hello world, and we replaced hello by hi. So now it says hi world completely in capitals. So now what we could do is we can also say, okay, we want to capitalize the first letter of every word and make everything else lowercase. Then I can also paste the function that I just showed you in between this, in the start case here. So if you're open, if you're close, okay. And now if I were to run this, then you see that it says hi world. So just so you know, you can also nest these things in each other, and I think that can also be quite handy. Then you have trim. Trim, I have to say, I'm not using so often, sometimes. So what it basically does is it removes space characters at the start or end of a text. So sometimes what I do is I do trim for example, the first name when I would send an email address, because sometimes people fill out space after their name inside a form because they maybe try to complete their full name. I'm not sure why these spaces are in there, but I already noticed it quite often that there will be a space after the first name. And then if you use trim, then this space will be gone. Now then we have upper. Now upper, it already says it here. It basically converts everything to uppercase. So here, if I say upper, and then here, if I would have Emma, which is now completely in lowercase over here, then I click save, I click run once. Then here I click send. And then you see that we get the data, and now you see that we have this word completely in uppercase. Now then we have substring. I have to say I've never used it, but it's there if you want it. So it basically gives you the portion of a text string between the start position and the end position. So here you have hello, and then you have 0 till 3, and then you get hell. If you have 1 till 3, then you only get L. Now then you also have index of. So this basically returns the position of a letter in what you give. So here, if we have IntegraMod, we say, okay, we want to know the position of T. Then here you get 2. As here, you see T over here. So I always find these countings a little bit confusing. So T, then here I would say this is 3, but it works like this, I guess. So I is like 0, 1, 2. And that's how they count in IntegraMod. And then if there is an X, which is not in this, then it gives you a -1. It also explains it here. The method returns -1 if the value search for never occurs. Now you have then that. Then you have to binary. So you can make something binary if you want to. I've never used that as well. Didn't find a need for that. Then you have to string. So I have to say I've never used that as well. I didn't find a use case for it. But if you know a cool one, let me know in the comments below. Now then you have encode URL, decode URL. So certain things in URLs, they cannot be there, like a space character, for example. So here, if I would do encode URL and I have hello world, a space cannot be in a URL. So when I do this, then it's going to change that to hello %20, which is the code for spaces in URLs. Then it will give you this. So you have that. Now, then you also have here decode URL, which basically does the opposite. You see here, automate your workflow, %20 is here, change to space again. Now, then you have escape HTML. So it escapes all the HTML tags in the text. I have to say, I've never had the need to use that, but it is there if you want to. So then here you see we have some HTML, and then it just changed it to this. Now escape markdown. Now you see also here basically just the same thing, but then with markdown, so this thing, the bracket is changed to this. And then we have strip HTML. Strip HTML I find quite handy sometimes. Because sometimes I get a HTML email and then I want to change that into a regular text that I can push through IntegraMod. So then here you see if we have hello and we make that bold with HTML, then if we strip the HTML, then we just get hello back. So that can also be handy for some cases. Now then we have contains, and it will give you back a true or false. So here we have hello world, and then we say, okay, is hello in it? Yes. So then we get back true. Now you can also do it the opposite. So hello world, does it contain by? No. Okay, then we get false. So can also be useful for some use cases. I use it in some cases with automated webinars and stuff, but otherwise I do not use this so often, but it can be really handy in filters maybe also. Okay, and then we have split. A split I think is quite handy. I'm using it sometimes, for example, inside emails. So what split allows you to do is like, it allows you to split a value depending on what you give it. So here, for example, we have John, George, Paul. John, George, Paul. So we want to split this by the comma, because then we get John, George, Paul as separate values. So you can use it for that. But what I find it really handy for is that, for example, if you have a tool and this tool only gives you a full name and not separate variables, basically for first name and last name. So what you can then do is you can say here split. And then what I can do here, I can say, okay, I want to split here. I have full name Emma Doe. And I want to split this by a space. And what you have to keep in mind here, if I click space, I click OK, it is saved. If I open it again, that space is gone. So to do that, you have to go here down here to keywords, and then we go down to space. So now the full name will be splitted by spaces. So if I click here OK, I click here run once, and then here I send some data over. Then boom, now over here, you see that we have a collection of arrays. We have Emma, Doe as two separate arrays. Then we can use these inside next modules, for example. So here, if I would add a Gmail module, I will say, okay, send an email, send that email to, now then the email address variable, for example, hey there. And then here we want to say, hey, and then we would want to say Emma. And then to do that, what we can do here, we can say, okay, I want to get. So here you go to the general functions. I want to get. And then we go back here. We want to get this collection of arrays. And we want to get the first one. So then I click OK. And then now, if I click here, run once, if I click send, and we go back over here, then you see that it sent the email, or the content in the email started with, hey, Emma, so only the first name. So this is really handy for that. And then again, what you can do is you can also say here, start case. And then here, I'm going to change this to hey. And then you see that we do all these things. And if you want, what you could even do, you can also just use this inside your email. So you can also just say here, this. So I think this always gets a little bit confusing, but if you want, you can also do completely without this module. So now if I do this, I send an email, okay, we get some data, email will be sent, and then you see that it now says content, hey, Emma, because first we splitted the full name, then we got the first value, and then we converted it to start case. So yeah, if you want, you can also use everything inside one module to save maybe some operations for having to create this set variable module. Then we have some other stuff. So here we have MD5, SHA-1, all these code things, basically. So I'm not a programmer. I never worked with those. So I can also not explain how these work, but they basically convert something to some kind of code format. So yeah, that's basically how to use the text and binary functions. So we have all these things. And what you just have to keep in mind, you just put this in here, you put a value in between, and then that function does something to that value. So yeah, I hope this was helpful. I also created a cool Integromat cheat sheet, which you can find in the description of this video with some tips and tricks that I learned over the last few years. And if you have any questions about text or binary functions, be sure to put them in the comments below, and I'll be super duper happy to help you out.